Hi, this is Darlene with Digital Photo Mentor, coming to you with the Luminar AI news update. It's January 21st, 2021, and the folks at Skylum have rolled out their very first update to their flagship product, Luminar AI, version 1.0.1. There's a few new things in the user interface, some tweaks under the hood, and quite a few bug fixes. If you enjoy this video, please remember to like it and subscribe to the channel. Let's dig in and see what's new. For the purposes of the demonstration today, I've chosen two different images so that you know whether I'm in the old version or the new version. So today the yellow flower represents the old version, and when you see the pink flower, that's the new version. So I'm going to show you the original version, and then I'll show you what's changed. The first thing you'll notice is that the under the plus sign in the old version, the original launch version, you'll see add folder with images and add single image as text. Let's pop over to version 1.0.1 and see what the change looks like. So now you'll notice pink flower, new version. Under the plus sign, now you have icons. So it's handy and easy to tell if you're adding a folder of images or just a single image. The next change that is also very subtle but helpful is under the template panel at the top. In the original version, there was no scroll buttons to go left and right when you're at the top here to see the suggested templates for this photo. So unless you had a mouse or a trackpad or something that would scroll side to side, it was actually difficult to see these templates and see the suggestions. So again, a small improvement, but very useful. Now I'm back in the original version, 1.0.0. You can see the yellow flower. The biggest changes here have been in the edit panel. So let's take a look here. We've got the essentials down the right-hand side, creative, portrait, and pro. Down a little further, you've got the local masking tool, and at the bottom, you found the history. Now, apparently the panels were confusing to some people, so they've compressed them a little bit and tweaked this look of this panel. Let's see how it appears now. Pink flower, new version. Now you'll see that there are only three things on the right-hand side instead of six. All of the tools are now under one tool icon. The local masking is under a new icon with a brush. And history has now been moved up from the bottom, so it's with the other two. The next thing you'll notice is that the tools are all here and they're now color-coded. So the ones at the top are still essentials, and you can see that those are blue tones. And then scrolling down, you see creative. So these are the same names and same tools as before. They're just sorted a little bit differently, and you can find them easier based on the color coding. Moving down, we still have the portrait tools, and finally, professional. One of the tools in the creative panel has also changed a little bit. Go to the toning tool. Now, this is the original version, and you'll notice that it had started with an amount slider and then highlights, shadows, and balance. Let's take a look at how it looks now. Open up the toning filter, where you got the pink flower, so new version. Toning tool, we now have the amount slider. Shadows and highlights are now buttons. You can switch between them just by clicking the button that you want to affect. So I'm going to dial up the saturation on the shadows, adjust the hue to something sort of golden, and you can see that I can do something different with the highlights. So now you have shadows, highlights, and then balance is down below. So this one looks a little bit different, but basically functions the same. While we're still in the toning tool, I want to show you a couple of other neat little tricks that have been added. These are called tool tips. So if you hover over many of the areas that are clickable that don't have descriptions, such as these things right here, you can see I'm highlighting with my mouse. So it's like a little reverse arrow. If you hover over it, it says reset. So that tells you that if you click this, it will reset that tool. I'm going to try that. Okay, now you can see that all the sliders are back to zero. This one, if I hover over, you see is add mask. And this one is finally the disable or the toggle tool. So if I have this set to something that I can disable, basically it just turns it off and on. There are a few other things that you can hover over and see what they do, like this tool up here, which is the before and after split screen, a preview, and of course, zoom. Heading back into the catalog panel, you can see that various other tools have hover tooltips as well. So you can see add folder, down at the bottom over the eye, you can see that's the info panel. And down here, you can do the same, add album. Under the templates panel, when you choose one, I'll just pick one for example, hover over the little heart, and that shows you, you can add that template if you enjoy this look to your favorites. There's a couple of things that I want you to know about how to get and install this update. Go to the Luminar AI menu at the top and search for check for updates. You see that my version is currently up to date and I have version 1.01. If you're still on 1.00, it may pop up and show you that you have an update available. Now, as I mentioned, this is a soft update rolling out over the next few days. So if you don't have it today, check for it again by the 25th and you should see this update ready to install in your version. Once you've installed it, you also want to make sure to reinstall your plugins. So if you're using Luminar AI with Photoshop in Lightroom, for example, like I am, it's recommended that you uninstall them and it will ask you for your password. And then reinstall them. And what that will do is just sort of do a refresh in Photoshop and Lightroom so that it's pulling the right version of Luminar AI. So just to wrap up, besides these few cosmetic adjustments that are really to improve your user experience, there's also been some things done under the hood to tweak it, improve the speed, and fix some bugs. There was 11 major bugs fixed for macOS and 7 for Windows that could cause some major issues or might have been causing crashing. So if you had any issues, make sure you install the update as soon as possible to solve some of those bugs. If you want to see a list of all the bug fixes, just head to the Skylum website and look for their notice of this update. I'm looking forward to the next major update, which they've told us is coming soon, hopefully end of February or March, where we're going to see the Sky Replacement AI get a reflection tool. I'm excited for that one. Stay tuned, and at any time there are some new updates to Luminar, I will have them here for you in this channel. If you want to learn more about how to use the software, I have a Luminar AI Tutorials playlist for you here. Check it out. Thanks for watching, and remember to like this video if you enjoyed it, share it with friends, and subscribe to the channel. Until next time.